point in your life where you think, I've been there, I've done that. Got the t-shirt? I think you need Arnocorps.
It's been 2 long years and I still need to ask you right now. Are you ready for action?
Thank you. Exactly. That's the best introduction we've ever had right now.
I think so.
I did like that.
Are you ready for adventure?
Because it is true. The people do need Arnocorps in their lives.
Are you ready to become goddamn heroes?
That's why we're here. Came halfway around the goddamn planet. To bring the pump to the people, make them understand that they have inside of them the potential to be a hero.
This is an ancient tale that was bastardized. It's originally from Austria. It was bastardized 3 times and now on television. This one is called Terminator. Here it is. We're taking it back!
Celebrate.
Not assassins.
I might feel a bit better if I could have a high five.
Of course.
Hey.
You need a hug too.
Come on! Give a hug. Group
you
hug.
Can rub
group
that hug. Helmet.
Yeah.
Hug.
Come on! Feel it! Feel the love.
Fast! You're a bunch of goddamn ballsy heroes.
Hey, Tolton! I also see a lot of ballsy goddamn sheroes out there as well.
Hey! We forgot about all the sheroes.
And this is not the first time we've been here. You know, we were here in 2006.
Now they are even more prepared.
Exactly.
We've given them 2 years to kind of absorb everything and think about it, tell their friends about it. Absolutely.
Some people haven't heard of Arnocorps. So there are some.
I know. Beginning.
So I think we need to give a bit of an Arnocorps synopsis.
It's true. Well, Arnocorps started in Austria. And then we migrated to San Fantastic Bay Area. It used to be San Francisco, but we changed the
San
name.
San Fantastic.
It became San Fantastic once Arnocorps was there.
Barracuda needs more guitar for Barracuda. We need more guitar for these guitar people right here.
And we are taking back the ancient tales of lore and mythology that have been bastardized, that have been exploited through Hollywood blockbuster bastardizations, you know, these these movie films. Movies like The Predator, Total Recall, all the ones starring Arnold Schwarzenegger, or Schwarzenegger, the people call him. We call him Schwarzenegger. And let me tell you, he did this as this grand scheme, right? For many reasons. One, primarily, was to depict himself as the hero character in the, despite the fact that he's just an actor. He's not a true action-adventure rock stud like we are,
exactly.
Where we do it every
he's
day.
He's a rock stud.
Ah, look at this fantastic lady. Get out here. All right. Come on. Take care of the goods right here.
Exactly,
okay.
Yeah.
Exactly.
International rock studs. Ballsy stud.
I want you to only repeat these vocals when I teach them to you. If you believe them about yourselves. All right, let's try it out. I'm ballsy!
I'm ballsy!
I'm a stud!
I'm a stud!
I don't take shit from anyone!
I don't take shit from anyone!
I'm ballsy! I'm a stud! I smoke my stogies wherever I want! I'm ballsy! I'm a stud!
These stories were meant to be told around a campfire or through song. They've been passed down for generations in the mountains of Austria, South Tyrol region, you know, those communities up there.
Mm-hmm.
It's all about the lore and mythology, singing the songs about the Predator, about, you know, the Total Recall stories that were exploited. So what we do is we bring them back to their original meaning and the original context of being told through music.
Go! reasonably similar? Are there not other stories that should be represented, like the story about a man who has a baby, or the story about a man who supervises children?
You gotta understand, when Hollywood gets its fingers into something, right, they'll use that actor that, you know, brought forth these ancient Austrian stories and bastardized them for, you know, political gain or monetary gain and stuff like that. And then they'll say, now you're going to be pregnant. Now you're going to do this.
I was trained in the beginning of a race choir. I got this whole range going on.
What about the story about the boy who came from Austria to another country and became governor of part of the country? What about that story?
That isn't an ancient tale.
Yeah,
no.
It's somebody trying to make their own story.
Right, exactly.
Exactly.
It was a grand scene. That's why he bastardized the tales in the movies, was so everyone eventually, when he would go into politics, would vote for him. We warned people. Our first show was at 924 Gilman Street in Berkeley, California, February 2001. And back then, we warned everyone in the audience. We're singing these stories, and everyone is thinking, hey, they're singing about the Schwarzenegger movies or something, right? And we're like, come on, you gotta understand something. He's gonna rise to power because of these stories. He will be ruling all of you if you do not watch out and realize these stories are meant to be told through music. Come on, stop watching those movies. Listen to our music instead, come on, and celebrate your own ballsiness.
See,
it's all about participation.
Exactly.
And then years go by, he became governor. Who's laughing now?
He's laughing now. He's laughing now.
They thought we were giving them the wrong advices, and Arnocorps just doesn't do that.
You can feel the pump, absolutely. You will feel the pump. Well, it's hard to describe, but it's kind of like an orgasm, the feel of it. It's this feeling you get when you're totally energized and your muscles, they start feeling tight and the blood is flowing around.
You start to pump up a little
bit. You know, if you, for example, if you're doing your squats. Usually we have our drummer demonstrate the squats because that is his specialty.
Do you think you could do
I'm better off at the lifts, but the squats, come on, it's just like this, but you usually have some weights on you, and you just drop in there, and you feel it right in the glutes. And what happens, that
which
is where...
You're better
at the push-ups. Maybe we should show them some of that.
Exactly,
yeah,
but that's for the pectorals.
You can feel the pump in the pectorals.
In the pectorals.
And I usually help them out a little bit.
Thanks for helping us warm up for tonight.
Exactly.
Because we're just eating food, and sometimes, you know, your metabolism is changing while you're eating.
Starts getting soft like marshmallow.
Yeah.
Don't make your ass eat like a marshmallow.
We always tell people, measure yourself before the show.
Right.
Always measure yourself. Get the tape measure. Get the measurement. It's starting to rain, goddammit!
It's crazy. It's fantastic. Look at that.
It's high quality stuff.
Yeah. Charcoal from burnt wood.
Yeah.
We used to use that. It wasn't good for the skin, right? So we switched to a cream. Well, the most important thing is they measure their self-worth before the show and after it. It's through the goddamn roof.
Through the roof.
Well,
we're all about empowerment.
Exactly.
Through the roof. Thank
exactly.
you.
You got
Thank
it.
Thank you.
All right. Exactly.
Thank you very much.
Come on.
Have a good concert.
Right. Thank you. You're going to be there, right?
I'm going to be there. Will you return to Belfast?
Of course. Well, we've done it once before.
Will you be back?
We will be back.